Now, with the new launch of the new website and 1 month's extension for the registration of the linkage of SIM card to the national identification number, a cross-section of Nigerians have commended the federal government's move. Plus TV Africa's correspondent Destiny Mwamwa has more.
The National Identification Management Commission just launched a new mobile service for an improved national identification number SLIP. Now, this is coming ahead of the deadline of April 9 for the expiration of the registration of the national identification number.
With over 200 million population in the country and the threat of jail term for those unregistered within the specified time, the task of registering everyone is quite Herculean. And so far, about 51 million people have registered. With the current development, and Nigerians are aware.
I saw the ad somewhere, I can't remember, maybe on YouTube or something. I know there was an app.
The digital app, I have it on my phone.
No, I'm not aware of it at all.
I'm not aware of that. I'm aware of it.
And with the development of this new web service, it is worthy of note that NIN registration cannot be done from the new web service, but only to access improved NIN slips.
This new application is not for new registration, please. It's actually for existing NIN holders to confirm and authenticate their information and be able to have their information, I mean, their name on the go, wherever they are. Know why at this moment in time and at this digital age, we still can't develop an app that will make people sit down in the comfort of their homes to register as a fresh, to have fresh registration.
You know, it's good, it's convenient. You can just input your code. Immediately your pictures, your data will just appear.
Some Nigerians are happy about this development and others say the app is not responsive.
I tried it one time, it was not working. They were just referring me back to something, so I just left the app like that.
I think the app is not perfect yet.
I've tried to log on it sometimes, I tried that, but I found out that it's not working as at the time.
I've gone through the new web portal. It's a little bit complicated, I must confess.
Do people truly pay for this exercise?
The experience was easy, but you have to pay for it before you could even get a form. I paid 35 for it.
Meanwhile, the federal government has extended the registration deadline from April 9 to May 6. The meeting had in attendance key stakeholders, including the chairman of the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC, who addressed the meeting and made it clear that the NIN SIM linkage would support the federal government in checkmating the activities of fraudsters and cyber criminals. Destiny Mwamwa for Plus TV Africa.
Well, for more on this, we're being joined by Monday Ubani. He is the former second vice president of the Nigerian Bar Association. Well, thank you for coming on board tonight.
Yeah, thank you for having me. Good evening.
Good evening. So in December 2020, you sued the federal government over its directive to telecom network providers to block all SIM cards that are not registered with the national identity numbers. In 2021, a federal high court sitting in Lagos ordered an extension of the deadline, and now the federal government has complied. How does that make you feel?
Well, I just heard about the news today that the federal government has extended the deadline just by 1 month. Mm-hmm. To me, that is clearly contrary to the judgment of the federal high court that was delivered on the 23rd of March, 2021. It is 2 months that the court gave as a judgment. And so any idea or any short change of reducing that month to only 1 month is clearly in violation of the judgment of the court. And I want to believe that they are not aware yet of the judgment. But what I have done is that I have collected a copy of the certified true copy of the judgment, which I have sent to the Attorney General and to the Minister and to all the service providers. I'm sure because of the holiday, they may now have gotten the letter. By Tuesday, which will be the resumption of duties all over the Federation. I'm sure they will get a copy of that judgment, and it is my belief that they will comply with the judgment of the court. Mm.
So as we speak, 51 million national identity numbers have been registered and verified. But that is just scratching the surface, right? Considering the nation's population, over 200 million. Now, the new deadline is May, like you said earlier. Are we looking at another push for further extension?
I think extension would be the best. In fact, I sought for 1 year from the court. Before the court gave 2 months. Then in the covering letter that I did to the Attorney General, and which I copied the minister and the other service providers, I asked for 1 year extension. I have this belief that Nigerians must not be under be made to undergo any harrowing experience or stress or any hardship whatsoever, occasioned by the virtue of the fact that they want to get their need. It is clearly uncalled for. There is no reason for that. If between 2012, according to you, and this is 2021, Nigerians have been able to register only 51 million out of 180-something thousand million subscribers, then it will be clearly impossible for over 120 million Nigerians to be registered between now and April or May, as the case may be. And so I think that the best thing and patriotic duty for any government official who is humane enough and love this nation is to actually extend the time, at least minimally, 1 year, so that Nigerians can register. If you watch out the process and procedure under which Nigerians are registering, it is under very stressful experience, and Nigerians are not finding it funny. More so, you have not diversified the process. Most times, the infrastructures and all that, the according to them, the laptops, are not working, sometimes no light, and then you cluster them in a location, endangering their lives and others. So I think it's not the proper thing. 1 year minimally would be okay for Nigerians, many more Nigerians to get registered.
You know, one very important point you made was simplifying the whole process. But let's talk about Nigerians. Is it that Nigerians only understand the language of deadline, ultimatum, and all of that? What's to say that if you extend by 1 year, people will not just go relax and say, oh, okay, we now have 1 year. I mean, let's just relax a bit.
My problem is that in everything we do in this country, you must undergo stressful experience. If these things are done in a simplified manner, I don't think Nigerians are disobedient to lawful instructions. You know, what I know that other countries do is that, like, look at this issue of INEC registration. When it was on, I think 2 years ago or thereabout, I asked my son to go and get registered. He was over 18 years, and he went, and they were demanding 500 naira for them to go and photocopy the form. After he photocopied the form with 500, they now asked him to pay 5,000 naira before he could get registered. And the young man walked away. And since that time, he has not been registered. If you make these things easier, simplify the process, there are many other agencies like local government areas can be used, come to the villages to register people. There's no way Nigerians will not. But when you now make it impossible, and then they go and then we start queuing up and then not having the process simplified and making it difficult for them, they will not show interest in it. So it is issue of government policy most times that discourage Nigerians, and they wait for lastminute.com. But if things are done in the manner that shows that we're civilized and encouraging people to do their civic responsibility, I don't think that Nigerians actually are totally disobedient. You know, I think Nigerians are really obeying, they obey their laws. You can see what is going on now with people clustering. A lot of Nigerians have been going to go and register, but the process is very discouraging. That is the problem. The government have not made it easier for Nigerians to actually go and register. And that, again, is what is, you know, causing people not showing interest in government policies like this.
Absolutely. The process is discouraging. But finally, let's talk about the National Identity Management Commission mobile app, which is supposed to make this whole process simpler, right? But there are reactions. If you watch the report put together by our Destiny Momo, most Nigerians are not even aware. Some do not even know what the app is about. Yes. Are you aware?
Yes. So that is the point, you know. It's the equation of the government agency that's supposed to be in charge of information, to disseminating this information to everyone. If I tell you what people, how many people have registered in the villages all over the country, the population is abysmally low. Why? Because one information is not given, you know, when it's supposed to be given, and the process of giving that information is also faulty. So that's why you see that many Nigerians are not aware. But I'm also aware of the app. A lot of people have even, you know, who are educated enough have used the app. But they still tell you that you have to come physically. That again is a problem. Even after you have undergone the process using the app, by the time you get there, they tell you all the ones you have done is rubbish. You still have to come and do a manual one through the process through which they can now extort money from you. Are you aware that people are paying money in order to get registered? People are paying 5,000, some are paying 10,000, some are paying 1,500. In my own local government, what they take is 1,500, 2,000 to get people registered. So why are people paying for performing their civic responsibility? Why are they taking money? Are government not aware of this? And what have they done to stop all that nonsense that is going on, that people have been extorted, you know, from? So I think that the government have a lot to do. And they do everything. Simplify the process. Get more people involved. Use the local government council. And then use villages in order to do this registration. So by the time you are deadline, is all over. You find out that many Nigerians, over 90% or 99%, would have registered. But through this process now, I assure you that even 3, 4, 5 years' time, more Nigerians will not actually be captured in the data.
Mm. Based on this eyewitness report you just made, it looks like the regulators have, you know, I mean, a big, tall order, I mean, when yes. It comes to making this whole thing work for Nigerians. But that's a safe place for us to land. Thank you so much for your insights, right?
It's my pleasure. Thank you for having me.
Thank you. I have been speaking with Monday Obani. He is the former second vice president of the Nigerian Bar Association.
Hello. Hope you enjoyed the news. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the notification button so you get notified about fresh news updates.